Good afternoon, dear students. Here, I'm here for your English. Now, today, we will go for the textual, that is the literature part. And dear children, you know, we, the people, how many people are there? Your father, your mother, your grandparents, your uncle, you know, and the others also, neighboring people also, those who are staying, you know, what they do, what? Can you tell me about your parents, how they concern you, how they love you? Yes, you are correct. Your mother takes care of you, especially when you go to school, she prepares food for you, packs the lunch and pack your bag also. Till you sit in the auto or till you sit in the van, your mother is back of you from morning. What about father? Father also concerned for you. He also loves you very much. Yes, no, dear children. The father brings us for the all the material which we need. Here, like this, actually in our neighbors also, uncle, aunt, they also love us very much. They concern us. Here, we are learning, dear children, in the sixth standard, the first unit is of our the care and concern. Care means to take care, means kaalji ghene, right? That is called, we call the care, the concern. That first unit is care and concern. And in that care and concern, in the first unit, we have, dear children, the two lessons and one poem. In all the units, one moral they have given in our English textbook, which you have this, the new textbook. All the units, you have the three sections in that. In that section, two lessons are there and one poem. And complete these two lessons and one poem, the one moral that is unique is about the care and concern. Yes, dear children. So, here, can you tell me the caring person? What are the qualities of the caring person? Now, I'm telling you. For example, now you are very small. We'll talk about your parents. They care. Just now, earlier I discussed that. Your mother cares for you. Mother cares from morning. Then, as you come from the home, from the school, she takes back from you. She serves you the meals, and then she take out your uniforms and all, and then she asks us to sit. So like this, because they concern, they love, they care you. So how many people are there? Can you tell me? See, can you see this web diagram? What are the qualities of caring person? Those who love you, those who care you. What are the persons? See, we the teachers, we here in the school, we are your father and mother. We care you. If something happens to you here, the teachers are the first person, they look after you. Okay, what happened to you? See, this is the caring and the loving. We concern you. So what are the qualities of the caring person? Those who love you, those who care you, what are the qualities of those personality? See here, a caring person. I have drawn here the web. You can understand. Here I have written, you know, my whatever is there. So you may have many qualities more than this. It is not the this much only whatever the madam has written, that much qualities. No. Qualities may be much more. So here first I have written, those who concern, that people, they are always friendly with you. What about the friends? Friends talks with each other, share the things with each other. sad things, the happiness and the sorrows we share, they are always friendly. They talk about everything with about ourselves. That is a caring person. Here, whatever the qualities I have written in the web, that are those are the qualities of a caring and caring personality. Help in need. Whenever we are in need, so these people, those who love us, those who care us, those who concern us, they always are there to help us in any situation. And the second is, they worry about us. They worry. Now you just take that, okay, if you are not feeling properly, if you have some problem and if you are sitting in a tension, then your parents, your uncle, your aunt, your elderly persons, you know, elderly person, maybe the grandparents, maybe chacha chachi, nana nani, anybody, so they worry about us. Understand? They worry about us. And the third thing is, they are always the good listener. Caring person always listen good. Now suppose from morning 8 o'clock till 4 o'clock, 4:30 or 1:30, 2 o'clock, or whatever your school timings are there, if you are here and whatever, you know, some children are there, they have habit, whatever happens in the school whole day, as soon as they reach at home, they tell their parents. Then there must be those who love you, those who care you, those who concern about you, you know, they always listen. Okay beta, now sit, you tell what happened all day. Why they are listening? Because they love you, because they care you. So they must be the quality of the caring person is a good listener. What is the other? Ready to spend time. Extra time. Ready to spend extra time. Now we have taken the parents. You can say anybody. Now if your brother is there, if your sister is there, elderly brother, elderly sister, if you are saying that, hey, this some, okay, this grammar, bhaiya, I cannot understand. Can you explain me? So what the brother or sister says? Yes, come. Because why they are saying yes? Because they care for you. So they are taking their own time. Their own time they are taking out, keeping aside, and they are giving that extra time for you. So the people, those who love, those who concern, they take out our extra time. Ready to do some extra work. Extra work also. If we are telling it, the parents, for example, now if you are telling your, now you are very much busy and doing something, mommy, can you please iron my dress? Can you do please pack my this one time bag? Even though today I don't have time. So your parents, your elderly, I'm talking about in the families, but many people are there, they love, they care outside, even the school also. If you are telling time, the teachers, their teachers are not telling, now period is over, now you cannot ask me. No, teachers are concerning you because they are ready to spend time, because they are ready to do some extra work. Many teachers are there, when the children ask them the difficulties, they are ready to spend the extra time. These are only the few qualities I have written here, those who care and concern about us. This I have told about, they love you. What about you, dear children? You also concern your parents, na? Yes, you also. What you do with your parents? What the girls, especially the girls always helps in the kitchen. Nowadays, not only girls, even the boys are also helping in the kitchen. Yes, na? Yes. Now, suppose sometimes mother says that, come on, dear, take these plates now. We have to sit for the meals, we have to sit for the dinner, we have to sit for the lunch. Take the plates and all, keep ready all the things for that on the dining table. So she's there. And what else you can do? Yes, the girls and boys can sweep house also. And little folks are also, they are also wiping and all that also you can do. What about the grandparents? Grandparents say, sometime give me, fetch me a glass of water. Oh, I can't see my spectacles. Can you give me, dear? You are there to help them. Sometimes our elderly people, the old people, they cannot walk properly. That time what you do? You take them, you hold their hand, then give support and you help them to take them out of wherever they want to go. Like this way, you also help. So not only the human beings, we the concern about the animals also, you know, all the pet animals or domestic animals, how we love them, they also love us. This is the nature, not only dear children, the animals and the human beings, but the surroundings. See all our nature, the trees, the plants, the flowers which bloom. If you go every day in the garden, when you talk, you take pour the water and just talk with them, definitely they also smile. So the care and concern, the environment, the nature is concerning about us, and that's why we are here to breathing our, we are breathing. Who is giving us air? Who is giving us sunshine? Of course, the nature. So they also care us. So we also care them. So in the whole environment, very, it is very necessary to care and concern. If we are not caring the nature, nowadays we are cutting the plants, we are cutting the jungles. Why? Don't cut. If we will not care the jungles, we will not cut the this one, definitely they will give us the more fresh air to breathe. Understand? So all these things are in the whole unit number one they have given. The second topic is about, you know, dear children, Helen and Keller. Few children might have heard that about the Helen and Helen Keller. You know, this Helen and Keller, she was blind from very small age, infant, when she was very baby. And as her parents come to know that she is blind and deaf also, वो देख भी नहीं सकती थी और वो सुन भी नहीं सकती थी. इस समय क्या किया? Then her both the parents, you know, father and mother, they were working. The working personality, the working people. So they had kept one maid for one lady for to take care of her, to look after her. And Helen Keller, as she was grown up, all the things that I'm not going to be told you now the very clearly, but very short I'm telling, that maid servant, she took care of her so nicely. And she, as she grown up, she was a famous writer. And she always tell that, Helen Keller, I am here, and she went in the college, she completed her college education, and after that she had written many books. She was a writer, and she always tells that because of that auntie, those who looked after me, because of her care and concern, I am here. See, we are here for this. So here the complete story is about, the poem is also like that only. So here the completely lesson is about that. Who has written this? Rabindranath Tagore, the writer of this lesson is Rabindranath Tagore. You know who is Rabindranath Tagore? Who was Rabindranath Tagore? Yes, dear children, you are exactly correct. What is our national anthem? Janagana Mana. Who has written them? This, the famous personality, the playwright, the poet, Rabindranath Tagore from Kolkata. Yes, he has born in 1861 and died in 1941. Indian poet, he's Indian. And author, playwright, musician also, and he was a very good painter also. Rabindranath Tagore, see, in one man, how many qualities? Painter, musician, writer, poet, and he won the Nobel Prize for the literature for his Gitanjali and collection of poems in 1913, Nobel Prize. Very great personalities only gets the Nobel Prize. So our Rabindranath Tagore, the writer of our national anthem Janagana Mana, he is the writer of this lesson, of this unit, that is care and concern. Now we will go to our first lesson. In that first lesson, the name of the lesson is a new doll. Who likes doll? Yes, you are correct. Especially, mostly 99.99% the girls like doll, even though they grow up, you know, 16 years, 17 years, 18 years, they like doll very much. So what they have given in this lesson? I will tell you little story, then we will go to our lesson. Here, the, you know dear children, here, how many characters are there? The three characters are there. Here is an old man, grandfather. Subhadra's mother and Kishanlal. These are the main three characters. Three characters are there. That is old man. We can write, can I drop this? Here we can write and here. I will drop this and the three characters, the main three characters are old man. He's a grandfather. 80 years old. And second character is Subhadra. Third character is Kishanlal. These are the main three characters. I will tell you story, then we'll read our lesson. So here we are talking about the new doll. Now when you are at home, dear children, here you read lesson number one. The first paragraph they have given, how to make a doll, you know. So try to make a doll. They have given here, you know, they have given how to make a doll. Now you are at home also, so you can make a, prepare a doll and see that. Okay, so here one man was there. He was an artisan, craftsman, a person who makes things with hand. So this old man, 80 years old, you know, this man used to make dolls with his hands, with different types of things he used to gather, and he makes doll. And he used to sell in a palace where the king and queen sleep. For their children, prince, for the princess, and for other people also, princess especially, he used to make all the dolls, and he used to go to a courtyard. In the courtyard, courtyard means the place where the palace is there, that angan is called the courtyard. He used to sell, he used to make with his hands, and there he used to sell. Like this, he used to earn money. But what happened after, when he was 80 years old, that time one new artisan has appeared in the courtyard, and his name was Kishanlal. He was too young and smart also, you know, 80 years old man, how he is making, and the new man, the very young man, he used to make the different types of dolls. Then slowly, slowly, all the people from that courtyard and there, they used to like the Kishan Lal's dolls. So they forget this 80-year-old man. And when everybody forgot him, the grandfather, this old man felt very bad. Then he said, he let it be. Then he has one daughter. So that daughter said that, okay, father, you come to me. Then this old man, he went to daughter's house to live in. Then daughter's husband means that old man's son-in-law. He said that we have little farm and you have to sit there and just you have to see if the animals comes here, you have to make them, keep them away from the field. That much only you have work. So he said, okay, we'll do. And this daughter has a girl. This old man's daughter has a daughter, means that old man's granddaughter. Her name is Subhadra. She always, you know, keeps her hands on grandfather's neck and always talk. So he also loves Subhadra always very much. Then what happened? Then she said that, grandpapa, you make me one doll for me now. Please make me doll. The old man said, no, I can't make now. No, you are the person, only you are the person makes the doll very perfectly and very good. I want from you only. So he said, no, the Kishan Lal is there. No, you are only the man. So he started making dolls for Subhadra. And that time Subhadra was how many years old? She was 16 years, not child, you know. Not a small child, she was 16 years old. But she forced, old man said, okay, let me do that. And accordingly he did. And then Subhadra said, let me go. I will take all these dolls. I will go in the palace courtyard. I will sell those dolls. Then her mother means that 80 man, this grandparents' daughter. She, how can you go? Who will take you all these dolls? Nobody will take. Then Subhadra says, no, I will go in the courtyard and I will sell. Definitely they will take. And she went, and then when she came, she brought, you know, mohar. Mohar means the gold coin. She sold that all the dolls and bought the gold coins. And when she brought the gold coin, then she showed her mother. She was very happy. And then when she was very happy, she said how. Then the grandfather told that, yes, you brought. Then she was very happy. She told, if we want again the gold, 5-6 gold more, if I will get, I can make you golden necklace for you, for your wedding, for your marriage. So again he made few old man, made few dolls, and Subhadra took all these things, all the dolls, and again went to the courtyard. There she sold and brought again gold coins. Then her mother was also very happy, and grandfather was also very happy. That time, then they made a necklace. Then grandfather said, only we need one now, groom. Groom means dula, jiske saath usko ek beti ki shaadi karni hai. That doll. And you know, this grandfather always used to tell the Subhadra, not Subhadra, Dadi. More Dadi, now I want groom for you. Ek dula ko mujhe tumhare liye, tere liye kya karna hai? Dhoondna hai. Then she said, no need to search. I have, the dula is also ready for me. So then grandfather asked, yes, where is he? Then she said, when I went all with the, all these dolls in the courtyard, the guard, those who were there, they told me, these dolls are not good. Now go from here. Nobody will take your dolls. So she was crying. And when she was returning back, that time, all boy, he had come to me. He said, you give me your doll. I have to make little bit the good clothes. Clothes, you know, on the dolls, we always keep the clothes. I will make little bit change on your this clothes, then they will take your dolls. Then he used to alter the dolls, used change the clothes, and he used to sell. Then she said that I will be very happy, grandfather, and if I will marry with him. That time he entered. Who? Kishanlal enters in their room, and they, it was finalized her doll. Then what this old man says, you made all the dolls, you sold in the courtyard, now you are taking my original doll. Who is saying this? The old man is saying, you are taking my original doll. Who is the original doll here? Yes, you are correct. Whose doll? That grandfather's doll is means Subhadra. Subhadra was 16 years old, na? That grandfather's doll. Then he said that you made all the dolls, but now you are taking my original doll. But I see here all the things. Who care for each other? Old man was making, he was selling there. After that, old man's daughter, she cared, she loved the old man. After that, the granddaughter and the grandfather, they were loving each other, they were taking caring each other. And the Kishanlal, he used to take the dolls and selling the dolls in the courtyard. Whose dolls? 80 years man's doll. Like this, they were concerning each other. The whole story they have given like this. See, as we go now, here I will read story lesson for you. You also pay attention when I'm reading the lesson. Whichever new words for you, hard words for you, underline with pencil. And after completing this lesson, you also read this lesson very carefully and take dictionary. Open your dictionary, find out the meanings of these hard words or new words and write in the textbook only. Should we start reading? Okay. There was a master craftsman who made dolls as playthings for little girls of the royal family. Every year a doll fair was held in the palace courtyard. All other artisans accorded the master the highest honor at the fair. When he was nearly 80 years old, there came a new craftsman. Youthful in age and fresh in his style, he was called Kishanlal. Of the dolls he made, some he would finish, others he would leave incomplete. Some he would color, others he wouldn't. It appeared the dolls hadn't been finished yet and never would be. Young people said, this man is brave. The old timer said, you call it courage? This is impudence. However, new times means new demands. Today's princes say, we want these dolls. The followers of old time says, अरे, what bad taste? Means, मतलब क्या है? अरे, ये तो कोई चीज़ें अच्छी ही नहीं है. पुराने ज़माने के लोग ये कहते थे, those who were like old man. This made the younger a lot more determined. Crowds didn't flock the old man's stall this year. Sare ke sare log naya jo Kishanlal hai usi ke paas jaate the. Now nobody was turning to the old man. His doll sat inside the basket and kept grazing wistfully like people waiting for a boat to reach the shore. ओल्ड मैन ने जो भी डॉल्स विच एवर डॉल्स ही मेड नोबडी वाज टेकिंग सो ही क्वेप्ट ऑल द डॉल्स इन द बास्केट लाइक यू नो इन द अदर्स आर वेटिंग फॉर द बोट एंड फॉर टू गो द अदर एज सो सेम थिंग हैपेंड विद द ओल्ड मैन अ ईयर पास्ड बाय देन टू एवरीवन फॉरगॉट द ओल्ड मैन्स नेम Kishan Lal became the master craftsman at the Royal Doll Fair. The old man became heartbroken and was soon out of work. उसे बिल्कुल वो बहुत दुखी हो गया जब कोई उसके dolls खरीद नहीं रहे थे. He was very sad. He was heartbroken and he left the making the dolls. And at last his daughter suggested, "Come, stay with me." His son-in-law said, "Eat hearty, rest well, and keep an eye on our vegetable patch to chase away the cattle trying to enter it." They had a small farm. So, वहां रुको जो भी गाय भैंस जो बाहर के आते हैं जब वो अंदर आते हैं उनको हकालने के काम तुम करो उनकी ओल्ड मैन की डॉटर शी सेड और वो उनके घर में ओल्ड मैन अपने बेटी के घर में रहने के लिए आ गया द ओल्ड मैन्स डॉटर वुड फॉरएवर बी बिजी विद हाउस वर्क हिज सन इन लॉ मेड अर्थन लैंप्स व्हिच ही फेड टू द टाउन ही यूज हिज सन इन लॉ यूज टू मेक उसका ओल्ड मैन का जमाई ही यूज टू मेक द अर्थन पॉट मिट्टी के बर्तन बनाकर बाजार में जाकर वो मार्केट में जाकर उसको सेल करके इन दिस वे दे यूज टू अर्न मनी जस्ट लाइक ही डिडंट अंडरस्टैंड दैट टाइम्स एंड चेंज द ओल्ड मैन सीम ऑब्लिवियस टू द फैक्ट दैट हिज ग्रैंड डॉटर वॉज नाउ अ गर्ल ऑफ 16 ईयर ओल्ड ईयर्स गर्ल सीटिंग अंडर अ ट्री एज अ ओल्ड मैन guarded the vegetable patch often dozing off his granddaughter would come and put her arms around his neck from behind this made the old man very happy he would say what is it dadi what do you want to whom you say he used to say dadi jo subhadra naam ki uski beti ki jo 16 saal ki beti thi usko wo pyar se kya kehta tha dadi kehkar बुलाता था एंड व्हाट डू यू वांट द ग्रैंडडॉटर वुड से मेक मी अ डॉल आई विल प्ले विद इट दिस 16 ईयर ओल्ड गर्ल वाज सेइंग टू हर ग्रैंडफादर यू मेक मी अ डॉल आई वांट टू प्ले विद अ डॉल द ओल्ड मैन वुड आस्क नाउ व्हाई वुड यू लाइक माय डॉल Does anyone make better dolls than you? The granddaughter would reply. वो कहती थी, आपके सिवा तो कोई भी अच्छा डॉल नहीं बनाएगा. आप ही तो बनाते हो. The old man would say, Why Kishan Lal does? Old man कहता है, क्यों अभी जो नया आया है Kishan Lal, वो भी तो मेरे जैसा ही बनाता है बढ़िया. So she said, Not a chance. कोई चांस नहीं. सिर्फ आप ही हो जो बेहतरीन गुड़िया डॉल बना सकते हो द गर्ल वुड से आफ्टर काउंटलेस राउंड ऑफ हिज सेम आर्ग्यूमेंट द ओल्ड मैन वुड टेक आउट हिज रॉ मटेरियल्स फ्रॉम हिज क्लोथ बैग एंड फिक्स हिज थिक राउंड ग्लासेस टू हिज आईज टू हिज ग्रैंड डॉटर ही वुड से बट दादी द क्राउड वुड ईट अप द कॉर्न्स यदि मैं यहाँ पर बनाते बैठूंगा तो खेत के ऊपर ध्यान कौन देगा सब कुछ आकर वो चर लेंगे वो खा लेंगे सो शी वुड रिप्लाई दादा आई शैल चेज द क्रो अवे मैं जाऊंगी दादाजी आप बनाइए मैं वो खेतों की रक्षा करूंगी द डेज वेंट बाय लाइक डेज द साउंड ऑफ ऑक्सन ड्रॉइंग वाटर फ्रॉम द वेल रीच देम द ग्रैंड डॉटर चेज द क्रोस अवे एंड द ओल्ड मैन मेड dolls the old man was utterly scared of his daughter wo jo aadmi tha old man subhadra ka dada ji apne beti se matlab subhadra ke mummy se kafi darta tha kyunki wo kafi gusse wali thi and she was strict and everyone in the family heeded her डिक्टेट्स, उसको हर उससे कभी भी वो हर कोई चुप कर रहता था, वो बहुत ही स्ट्रिक्ट थी, गुस्से वाली थी. द टुडे एनग्रॉस इन हिज डॉल मेकिंग द ओल्ड मैन डिडंट रियलाइज हिज डॉटर वॉज अप्रोचिंग हिम फ्रॉम बिहाइंड फेलिंग हर आर्म्स. That Subhadra comes and she was keeping her hands on his neck from back side. As she called out him, he took off his glasses and kept staring at her like innocent child. His daughter said, "The cow is yet to be milked and here you are wasting time with Subhadra. Is it her age to play with dolls?" उसकी मम्मी, सुभद्रा की मम्मी आके कहने लगी, आप क्या है, गाय का भैंस का दूध निकालना बाकी है, आप क्या ये लड़की के साथ खेल रहे हो, टाइम वेस्ट कर रहे हो, अभी क्या छोटी बच्ची है उसके साथ खेल रहे हो आप. His daughter said, "The cow is yet to be milked and you are here wasting time with Subhadra. Is it her age to play with dolls?" The old man babbled, means वो ऐसा uttered, whispered, "Why should Subhadra play with it? I will sell these dolls at the palace. The day my dadi gets married, she has to have a gold necklace. I want to save money for that." मैं ये वो क्यों खेलेगी वो गुड़ियों के साथ? मैं जो गुड़ियां बना रहा हूँ वो नहीं खेलेगी, मैं जाके बेचूंगा, उससे मैं कुछ खरीदूंगा और जब मेरी सुभद्रा की शादी हो जाएगी उसके लिए मैं सोने का हार बनवाऊंगा. Annoyed the daughter snapped at the palace, who would buy such dolls? कौन आपके dolls को अभी खरीदेगा? उसकी जो बेटी है बड़ी, वो उसके ऊपर डांट रही थी. The old man hung his head in shame and became quiet. जब वो जोर से चिल्लाए, बेचारा दादाजी क्या हो गया? गपचुप बैठ गया. Subhadra shook her head and said, "Let me see how anyone can stop herself from buying Dada's doll at the पैलेस." कौन देखता हूँ, कौन रुकता है मेरे दादाजी के डॉल्स को बेचते हुए, मैं तो जाके उसे बेचूंगी. A couple of days later, Subhadra returned with a gold coin and said to her mother, "Take this moha, gold coin, moha and price for my dada's doll." जो भी बनाया था जाके उसने बेचा. And whatever he brought, she gave to her mother. Mother asked, "Where did you get this?" The daughter said, "I sold the doll at the palace." The old man said with a chuckle, "Dadi, if only your dada could see better and see his hands wouldn't shake so much." उसका दादाजी हंसते हुए बोला, मैं और भी कुछ बना सकता था यदि मेरे हाथ शेक ना होते थे और मेरी आंखें और भी अच्छी देख सकती थी तो. Delighted, her mother said, "If you have just 16 of these mohurs, we can get a necklace for Subhadra." "No worries then," assured the old man. उसकी मम्मी, सुभद्रा की मम्मी कहती है, और थोड़े से डॉल रहते थे तो अपना पूरा नेकलेस बन जाता था. So Subhadra's grandfather said, "I will make it." Subhadra embraced her grandfather and said, "Dada bhai, no worries for finding my husband." The old man started laughing as he would wipe a drop of tear off his eyes. The old man had found his youth back, sitting under the tree. He would make dolls as Subhadra chased away the crows and the oxen pulled out water from the well in the distance. One by one, the 16 mohurs were in place, now strung into a beautiful necklace. जो भी जो gold coins, 16 gold coins थे, उसका पूरा उन्होंने क्या बनाया? एक बढ़िया सा सोने का necklace बना लिया. The mother said, "Only the groom is missing." अभी necklace तो तैयार है सोने का, अभी दूल्हा कहाँ है? दूल्हे को तो ढूंढना जरूरी है, शादी करना है तो. Then Subhadra whispered into the old man's ear, "Dada bhai, my groom is ready." Subhadra apne dadaji ke kaan ke paas jaati hai, "Dulha bhi kya hai? Tayar hai." Then grandfather asked, "Tell me dadi, where did you find him?" Phir wo kehta hai, "Tumko kahan mila ye dulha?" Subhadra said, "The day I went to the palace, the guard asked me what Was I therefore, जब मैं पहली बार पैलेस पे गई थी बेचने के लिए गुड़िया, तो उधर गार्ड ने मुझे क्या किया, रुका के रखा, उधर उन्होंने मुझे एंट्री नहीं दी. एंड आई टोल्ड हिम वांटेड टू सेल डॉल्स टू द प्रिंसेस. He said, "This doll won't send and turn me away." उन्होंने कहा ये इधर बेच नहीं सकते, तुम वापस चली जाओ. A man who saw me crying said, "Here, give me your dolls. If I alter the dresses a bit, they will sell very well." उधर एक लड़का मुझे मिला, उन्होंने कहा कि वो तुम्हारी गुड़िया मुझे दे दो, मैं उसको थोड़े से अच्छे से कपड़े सिलवा दूंगा और उसे बेचूंगा. If you like this man, Dada, I shall be very happy to put the garland around his neck. The old man asked, where is he? फिर उसके दादाजी ने पूछा, वो कहाँ है? There under the pear tree, replied the granddaughter. The groom to be entered the room. The old man said, अरे, this is Kishan Lal. जब वो बता ही रही थी कि उनके घर में किसने एंट्री की, एक लड़के ने जो बहुत सा अच्छा था, और वही तो फिर जब ग्रैंडफादर उसको देखता है तो कहते हैं, अरे इज किशन लाल ओनली. किशन लाल टच द ओल्ड मैन्स फीट एंड सेड, यस आई एम किशन लाल. द ओल्ड मैन एम्ब्रेस्ड हिम टाइट एंड सेड, माय डियर वन, dear, one day you had snatched the dolls I had made. क्या कहा पता है क्या कहा, जब मैं बना रहा था तो तुम आए मेरे जगह पे, मेरा सारा बिजनेस धंधा चौपट कर दिया, सारे मेरे डॉल्स को ले लिया. अभी जो है तुम क्या लेके जा रहे हो, मेरी ओरिजिनल गुड़िया को लेके जा रहे हो. हु इज द ओरिजिनल गुड़िया, दादाजी की ओरिजिनल गुड़िया कौन थी? यस यू आर करेक्ट, सुभद्रा. सुभद्रा चलती फिरती गुड़िया थी जो कि दादाजी की गुड़िया थी. फिर वो दादाजी कह रहे थे, अब तो तुम मेरे ही ये ही वाली गुड़िया लेके जा रहे हो. द ग्रैंड डॉटर पुट हर आर्म्स अराउंड द ओल्ड मैन्स नेक एंड विस्पर्ड टू हिम, दादा विद यू इन टाउ. देन टो मींस यू नो द टोस, इफ यू आर कीपिंग vehicles on the unparking area, the police comes and they tow the vehicle and keep in the police station the tow. So she say, the granddaughter put her arms around the old man's neck and whisper to him, dada with you in tow. To wo usi ki tarah se Kishan Lal ne usko wahan se utha liya. So in this complete lesson we have learned about the care and concern about each other. Dear children, read the lesson very 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 carefully. I hope you understood this lesson. Thank you and have a nice day.